Today is definitely one of those days when I'm like completely lost and I'm trying to figure out like what am I doing, why am I doing this, what next, and when will I make a decision, or rather who will make the decision and all those stuff. The day started with following up on the actions from yesterday, which is like going to the schools and asking about the application forms and all the stuff. So I was in fact like prepared to go to one specific school, fill up the form there and attach all the necessary proofs rather, and give it and come back and probably check with one more school is what I was thinking of. But the way it turned out, like I missed carrying one specific document, and that meant that I had to come back home and go back again to give it. But while doing so, I made sure that I also visited another school and I just checked with them like about what is the situation with the admission at their end. And they were in fact like telling that they're already open for admission. Like that was a little bit surprising, but they told that I need to submit the application form, go through a round of interview, and then they even told what's the money that is involved with admission. And in fact, like they have a kind of different course structure. It's like, it's not like a typical nursery, LKG, UKG. They have something like a Montessori 1, Montessori 2, and Montessori 3 kind of structure. So, and apparently their application was way more expensive than what I imagined. So in fact, like I kind of like came back home. I thought like, okay, let me go back and take my wife along and just show them both the places. So we went to the first place, dropped the application form with the necessary new or the missing proofs. And then we went to the second school and then again picked up the form there, filled it up and gave it back. So we need to go back for an interview on Saturday. Once we came back, that's when the bigger confusion started. Like, she's not convinced with, I mean, when I'm talking about she, it's like I'm talking about my wife. Like, she's not convinced about the fact that we need to send my daughter to a co-ed school, and especially something which is straight syllabus. So she's very much specific about sending her to a girls only school, be it nursery or LKG or high school, wherever. And again, having said that, she herself has studied in a Christian school, so she knows about the discipline and all the strictness that they come up with. So that kind of like kicked in a long conversation about why I am not specific about sending to specific schools, which is like slightly far. When I say slightly far, I'm literally talking about 5 kilometers away from my house, and why I am okay with sending my kid to the one which is near my house, or probably take a chance with a non-typical school thing for the nursery and then going ahead with the proper school from LKG onwards. It's kind of like a very intense conversation which has left me in a bit of confusion, like what next. Now fast forward to the evening when I send these details in my family WhatsApp group. So night, like sometime back, when my sister called me up, so she was asking about, okay, I see that you have started giving the application form. Just see if you can get a reference from somewhere so that you can get the admission in the place where I gave the form in the morning, the first place. Now, she is very pushed and willing to support me to make my kid join there. I'm kind of, yes, convinced there, but I'm pretty sure my parents are. But the question now is about, how do I convince my wife, because she has some other school in the mind. So again, that school, probably it's on Saturday, or I think it's on Monday that the application process will start. So we'll definitely apply. And again, all the interview thing has to go through, and we'll have to figure out about the donations and all those stuff, because most of the places, they're literally asking like 60, 70 or 80,000 rupees as donation, which is outside of the fees. So let's see how that goes. But this has like literally torn me into pieces. Like my mind is completely confused and lost about what next, how, why, and all those things. Because I'm not sure if I'll be able to convince any single person like why I took a certain decision. Because end of the day, it's about school, it's about education, it's about future, and I need to make sure that I take a balanced and a well thought of decision. So I'm still lost. Even when I'm talking about this, I'm still lost about that. Anyway, it's good that a friend of mine from my writing community, whom I think I spoke about yesterday, he is continuously messaging me and keeping me informed about the things that he is doing and like what are the schools that he is going and what research he is doing about all these things. So somebody is kind of like helping me out as well, I can say. So that kind of helps. So the struggle is real. So let's see how things go. Saturday there is one interview, and next week Friday there will be an announcement for an interview in the school where we gave the application form in the morning today. And next Monday I need to fill up an application form in a school where my wife prefers to send my daughter. Wow, it's too much confusing. It's confusion is similar to the rides that we have over the next few days. That's like on Sunday and Tuesday. Tuesday being a Republic Day. Sunday there is one ride. I think there's no confusion about that. But me being a part of five different groups, and most of the groups are planning for a ride on Tuesday. It's getting confused, like which ride, who is coordinating, what time, where I have told yes, where I have not told, and all those things. I can go only for one ride on that specific day. I think I've given an yes in one particular location, but it looks like I might not go there. But I'm confused, like which one I'll go. So let's see how this goes. Like, I mean, as I told you, it's a completely confusing state of mind. While all this are happening, as if you can call it like adding fuel to the fire, I had this kind of like a conversation with my senior manager, a continuation to what we had yesterday. But today I had my team lead also with me. This was supposed to be our first call of the year, talking about the project status and all, a fortnightly catch up. But fortunately or unfortunately, it ended up being the last call because he's not available after next week. So this kind of becomes the last call. But while in the call, he did bring up a point about this whole thing about how or where our project is headed to and how it gets restructured or whatever, the direction. He just gave clues. He didn't say what exactly is happening. Maybe he didn't want it to, because, I mean, end of the day, we get a little bit worried and all, or probably start talking to others after he left, then it might leave a bad impression about him. But whatever clues he left does not sound very positive from what I see. And I'm also trying to see if that is also the reason why he's leaving, because he knows what is happening, which might not be good. I mean, that's what I gauge it. So let's see how things goes. I really don't know. Like, I mean, for now, I think I'll concentrate on this kids' school thing for the next few weeks or whatever, until that is sorted. Then I'll start thinking about this office stuff. I mean, there has been backing in my house about thinking like, okay, go ahead, change the job. This is not the only thing in the wonder and all. But let me see. It's not that easy. I mean, once you're settled in a place for 10 years, it's really difficult to come out of the thing. But I'll keep you guys informed about what's happening. And I'll catch up back tomorrow, Friday tomorrow. So let's see how things goes tomorrow. So until tomorrow, take care. Bye-bye.